To the Get Healthy Talladega County Show. We are so excited that you've joined us today. We bring with us Terry Roller, the Superintendent of Education for Talladega City Schools. And in our second segment, we will have Marshall Pritchett, who is a UAB med student located here in Sylacauga. We will be right back after these messages.
Hi, it's Shawnee McNeil at South First Bank. This is a great time for you to buy or build a new home, or maybe refinance your present mortgage. Our rates are the lowest they've been in years, and that means saving you money. We've been helping our customers become homeowners in this area for nearly 70 years, and we can make our approvals right here in the office, and that means saving you time. We're located here in downtown Sylacauga. Come in and find South First, a better way to bank.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
At Marble City Pharmacy, we're more than just a drugstore. Our gift shop boasts some of the most unique treasures you'll find anywhere. Come in and browse the vast selection of jewelry, purses, clothing accessories, and crafts. Let our friendly staff help you find that special card or gift for any occasion. Our dollar wall features selected sale items, and we stock a wide variety of specialty items. And if it is a drugstore you need, Marble City Pharmacy was named the 2015 McKesson National Pharmacy of the Year. Visit us today at Marble City Pharmacy.
Connect to nature. Connect to family. Camping World is here to help you make lasting memories. With thousands of parts and accessories available, service nationwide, and RVs as low as $109 a month, Camping World has it all. Now is your time to connect to excitement with savings on thousands of RVs. Plus, enjoy Good Sam Elite membership with every RV purchase. Visit your local Camping World Supercenter or shop campingworld.com today.
The Allen Companies of Sylacauga, with three locations to serve you: Highway 511, Highway 280, and Main Avenue. For all your convenience store needs, ice, drinks, snacks, and of course, some of the lowest price gasoline at the pumps. It's the Allen Companies of Sylacauga. Highway 511, Highway 280, and Main Avenue. It's the Allen Company convenience stores.
Welcome back to the Get Healthy Talladega County Show. And as I mentioned in the introduction, we have Terry Roller with us today, who is the Superintendent of Education for Talladega City Schools. Welcome, Mr. Roller.
Thank you so much. Very happy to be here.
Well, we're glad that you are here with us today. You have been the Superintendent of Education for almost a year now.
We are just
so excited to have you as the superintendent for Talladega City. There are lots of exciting things that are going on
That's right.
I want to hear from you and for the audience to hear about Talladega City today. But before we start that, I always like to just kind of find out about you, about okay. about the journey that has brought you here to Talladega City and as the superintendent, and so the audience can get to know you as a person as well as the superintendent.
That's a great idea, because you know educators are so different than many other professions and work fields. You know, people do a job, but educators are. So it's really hard for us to separate what we do and who we are. Mm-hmm. And so this whole segment and all the work that you do is incredibly important to me, because growing up a single parent kid, there were three of us, you know, nutrition and being healthy was something that was a very real part of our existence, whether it was we're always trying to, you know, find healthy, nutritious things. Mm-hmm. You know, you talk about those deserts, those food deserts in certain communities, and it was certainly something that you could see even as a child with me growing up. And so this is something that I'm very passionate about. You know, single parent, three kids. I was actually 2 months premature, low birth weight. I was a 4-pounder. You know, you wouldn't know it now. I think my beard weighs 4 pounds.
You made up for it.
so you know, but this is something that's incredibly important to me. You know, I was an athlete growing up, so I had opportunities to train and certainly, you know, work on making my body stronger. And what I found from that is that when I felt better and looked better, I behaved better. You know, my self-image, my self-identity, my self-worth, I felt like increased because of being healthier. And so that's something that we're trying to do for our students daily, is find ways to connect with them with things to improve their self-image and self-identity and self-worth. I left being an athlete and became a teacher. So I spent time in Jefferson County teaching school. Love to travel, would take students on trips. We started out doing trips, you know, national trips, and eventually evolved to doing international trips. I think I probably have been to 25 international cities. From there, I became it was great. Loved it. Was an assistant principal in Shelby County for a while. Started my administrative career as a principal in Talladega County. So I was a principal in Lincoln for nearly 10 years. One of the best experiences of my life. So when I had an opportunity to come back to Talladega County proper and, you know, work with Talladega City Schools, I said, this will be great because the students and the children in all of these communities are so similar. And they're some of the best young people I've ever worked with. And I feel like it's part of my life that's, you know, a very integral part of my life. And it was like coming home, you know. So,
well, one thing that those of us who have gotten to work with you over the past year is you have a passion for what you do. Right. You have a passion for the students. You have a passion for the community. And as we are, you know, we're here, Get Healthy Talladega County. That's and right. We have that tagline of mind, body, spirit.
That's
and,
right.
You know, and to have a leader like you, it's just been so refreshing. You have been a breath of fresh air.
Well, thank you.
And
thank you.
It's been exciting to see some of the initiatives, some of the, especially the enthusiasm that you have for making sure the students are healthy, mind, body, spirit, and everything that goes into that. One of the things that we wanted to start off talking about was branding.
Yes.
You have some new things going on.
And, we do.
And let's talk about the branding and what that means when you had mentioned some the mind, the body, the spirit, and how that interacts.
Yes,
and,
I would love to do
yes,
that.
Yes, share that with...
Well, so in today's world, you know, there's constantly a flow of information and images and likenesses that you can access in seconds. And so to not take advantage of the brand that you really embody, that you're really selling to people every day, you know, you have to do that. And so what we did, the city of Talladega used a company out of Birmingham, and this company rebranded the city. And that happened, and they were finishing that up right about the time that I was coming on as superintendent. And so they sort of made an arrangement and a deal. Hey, listen, you did a great job with us. Why don't you work with the city so that as us being a city school system, we can have some continuity across both departments, right? So Sylacauga's a city schools. So it's important that they match up with what the city's doing. And so with Talladega County, it's very different because you have, you know, all the different schools and the different communities within the county. But for us, Sylacauga and Talladega, you know, you're tied directly to your city. So it was really important to me that we share some continuity with that. And so immediately we jumped in, we formed the committees throughout the different wards and different parts of the city. We started having the meetings where you talk about what really makes up Talladega. What are the non-negotiables? What are the things that really embody us? And we came up with these beautiful images, likenesses, and logos. And so one thing that most people don't think about is the fact that when you, say, copy a mascot from a school, well, you don't own that. And that's copywritten and trademarked. And so that's fine until something happens that's negative with social media being like it is. You know, those universities can see that their likeness is being used or misused. You get the cease and desist letter. So we didn't want any of that happening. So we've created our own images, likenesses, and logos. You know, we're distributing those and getting those out. Mm-hmm. And it was important to me because if you look good and people see things that look classy and professional, you feel better about yourself. Yeah. One of the things that I love about Talladega is the fact that the young people are amazing. Mm-hmm. Some of the most resilient, confident, hardworking, really talented young people. But our biggest challenge that we've been faced with since I've been here is perception. Well, that's also the hardest thing to change. So your schools could be doing really well academically. You could have a lot of positive things happening, but it's the perception and what people say about you that's so hard to change. But what's most interesting about that is that's what young people deal with every day. What are my friends saying about me? What are they, you know, how do they view me? Right. You know, what image is there of me, you know, amongst my peers? And so with this whole focus being mind and body and spirit, you know, it's important to me that we really focus on our brand and we put a quality, you know, professional thing out there, because the way you think about yourself, the way others think about you, ultimately affects you, your body, and lastly, your spirit. So it was very important for us to make sure that we focused on putting a high quality brand out there.
When we're going to be going to break in just a minute or two, but when we come back from the break, we've got a video, a promotional video that you brought with you today that shows the new brand. Okay. It has the new logo on it and has some wonderful student faces. And some of the different projects that are going on. So we look forward to hearing that. You had also, we might not need to start a new project, but I'm before the break, but I do want to hear about your goals.
Okay.
You've been here a year. What are just some of the things that you really want to see happen?
Well, again, you know, academic instruction is really, you know, the focus of why we're here.
Mm-hmm.
But when we first started our tour and our campaign back in the summer, the goal for me, we really addressed the people with the three E's. We were talking about excitement, engagement, and encouragement.
Mm-hmm.
And so those were our broad goals. Uh-huh. We want people to be excited about the work that we're doing. We want them to be excited about instructionally what we're doing. We want them to be excited about new projects that we put on the table. We want them to be engaged in what we're doing. Obviously, students are engaged athletically, you know, their clubs and things for them to participate in, career tech, student organizations, engagement with that. But we're talking about starting chess in our curriculum and having a chess club in every single school. Doesn't that affect the mind as well?
Boy, does it ever.
It does.
It does.
You know, I think recently there was a story about some rural area schools in the South that had students in middle school that were competing nationally in open divisions in chess. So do you think that changes the way a student approaches problem solving and how they feel about themselves? That's exactly what we're looking for.
So we're planning for the future.
It does. It really does. So we want students to be engaged with that. You know, being healthy is a big part of what the show is about and about what our partnership is about. And so, you know, we have three gyms that are under construction right now. So physical education is very important to us. So those gyms are under construction now. We're going to really try to motivate and encourage our instructors. We did a staff development recently where all of our PE teachers were challenged to go out and connect with the local professional organizations and national organizations and do grant writing and try to secure funding for additional resources so that they can have the best educational experience, even in physical education. So those are kind of our three big goals and how we try to group things underneath that.
Well, we will be back in just a minute. We're going to take a break and we'll come back with the video with your new logo on it as
Thank you.
And we'll be right back in just a moment.
Hi, it's Shawnee McNeil at South First Bank. This is a great time for you to buy or build a new home, or maybe refinance your present mortgage. Our rates are the lowest they've been in years, and that means saving you money. We've been helping our customers become homeowners in this area for nearly 70 years, and we can make our approvals right here in the office, and that means saving you time. We're located here in downtown Sylacauga. Come in and find South First, a better way to bank.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
At Fort Williams Pharmacy, you won't find motor oil, garden hoses, or mountain climbing gear. No, they don't have that. What they do have is a professional, friendly staff that understands your needs. Filling prescriptions is their primary business, and they take it seriously. They also have a drive-through window for your convenience and free local delivery. Most of all, Fort Williams Pharmacy knows your time is valuable, so when it's time to fill your prescriptions, you need it done fast, friendly, and accurately. Fort Williams Pharmacy, our family, caring for your family.
Connect to nature. Connect to family. Camping World is here to help you make lasting memories. With thousands of parts and accessories available, service nationwide, and RVs as low as $109 a month, Camping World has it all. Now is your time to connect to excitement with savings on thousands of RVs. Plus, enjoy Good Sam Elite membership with every RV purchase. Visit your local Camping World Supercenter or shop campingworld.com today.
Coosa Valley Medical Center, one of the top 10 hospitals in Alabama, is also Sylacauga's largest employer. Services from the emergency room, to surgery, to cancer treatment, to post-stroke care. You won't believe what's right in your backyard. It's Coosa Valley Medical Center in Sylacauga. So, if you're sick in Alabama, choose one of the top 10 hospitals in Alabama. That is Coosa Valley Medical Center.
Talladega City Schools sits nestled quaintly at the foothills of Cheehaw Mountain. A city of 16,000 residents and a school system of 2,000 students is connected by education. We have six schools focused on reaching students through exciting, encouraging, and engaging activities that prepare them for their careers. Everything that we do prepares them today for what they're going to do tomorrow. With hopes of opening three additional pre-K sites in 2017, TCS offers cutting-edge instruction for all students. Our elementary schools offer rigorous but personalized instruction with a low teacher-student ratio. We have chess classes and chess clubs in elementary school. 13 industry-motivated, high-intensity 21st century career tech programs are offered. Our junior high school takes pride in preparing our students for high school with a 1-to-1 Chromebook ratio and advanced offerings in career tech. Virtual learning opportunities enhance the curriculum to meet the needs of all students today for what they'll do tomorrow. We have a competitive archery team that ranks nationally. Recently, our junior high football team was an undefeated county champion. Even our robotics team is a leader in the region and ranks top 10 at the state competition annually. With many rich and vibrant opportunities, Talladega City Schools takes pride in partnering with local industry to equip students with mentoring, job shadowing, and internships. The core philosophy of Talladega City Schools is preparing students for their future. A crucial part to ensure we achieve our goals is getting everyone on the same page. Today, we share the first step of that process. A better tomorrow begins today.
Yeah. Love the tiger roar.
I love that.
Doesn't that make you proud when you're seeing all those faces of those students that
it
you
really
know
does.
And get to see?
And so if you look at that, mm-hmm. what you see is a very diverse group of students.
Right.
And an incredibly diverse group of class offerings and projects and activities and career tech organizations. And ROTC was ranked number one in the drill competition that they did mm-hmm. recently. You got a nationally ranked a state ranked robotics team. Just a lot of fantastic opportunities for students to be engaged in who they are becoming in the future. So I love that video.
I like that video too. I know a couple of those faces in there.
And yes.
It's just when you talk about the branding and the enthusiasm mm-hmm. and excitement, the three E's, that just plays into that. So much about improving the perception, as
correct.
You said.
And you have to be strategic about mm-hmm. what you're doing. And so what we were trying to do is focus people into where we needed them the most. We needed them to be excited about the work we were doing. We needed them to be engaged in the work that we were doing. And we needed them to be encouraging along the way while we're doing it. Because that mind part is so important to us, you know. The way that people perceive us and how we're engaging and moving about was really affecting the performance of our folks. We have outstanding students. And so we just needed to focus everyone in the right direction, say, look at what we're really doing and who we really are.
And you've got to believe. You can do it. And speaking with one of your principals the other day, you know, just now that, you know, the entire fifth grade mm-hmm. at Houston Elementary, they made A's and B's on their test, and now they know
that
they're capable.
They know
and
that
that's
capable.
Important, and they can believe it and know it. And so this is, I really like what you're doing and the enthusiasm.
Well, thank you.
You've talked about the new gyms that are coming.
Mm-hmm.
We talked about the branding mm-hmm. and your goals.
Correct.
You got pre-K
that's right.
coming
so,
up.
So what we know to be true is that students that participate in pre-K come with a greater opportunity of being ready for school to start in kindergarten, but actually having a fair shot at, you know, life. And so pre-K provides opportunities for young people to have those same types of experiences that traditionally you would get if you were in a daycare or some of those other places. And so it's good for us to have those in our schools because we can kind of focus and guide what the curriculum looks like and where they're going with it. So we've made application. We have one currently. We've made application for three additional ones.
Okay.
And we would love to have them. I think currently we probably have about 45 or 46 applications that have been submitted. You know, and we're ready to receive those young people. So we hope those grants come through because it's really about creating experiences and opportunities for young people to be successful. So, excuse me, instead of trying to figure out what's going on with students in grade 10, 11, and 12, let's get them in pre-K and let's set the system for them and then monitor that system and engage with them along the way. And then we know they'll be ready by grade 10. So that's what our goal is now. So super excited about that.
Mm-hmm. And I wanted to mention something that happened recently that we were all together at a meeting. Actually, it was here in Sylacauga where we had all of the primary partners for Get Healthy Talladega County together. And I was actually on a phone call just this morning with the two visitors that we had. One of them was from Washington and one was from Minnesota.
That's right.
First trip to Alabama.
Okay.
And one of the comments that they made was about the three superintendents that were there speaking about you and Dr. Lacey and Dr. Freeman and just what a dynamic combination that was. And she mentioned how well you all got along and worked together, and
that's
it was just a cohesive group, and that was just such an impression on
them. Well, I will go ahead and say publicly, I think I speak for Dr. Freeman in this. We both yield to Dr. Lacey. She might be 5'3", but she has real power.
Right.
Yes, ma'am, you do. Yes, ma'am. But, you know, it's really neat because I worked for her, and it's like family. So, you know, we collaborate on a lot of activities and programs. In the past, we've shared distance learning opportunities. We certainly will look at sharing career tech opportunities now. I have no problem at all with extending our hand to our neighbors in Sylacauga City and Talladega County. We make a great team, you know. Obviously, I'm the you know, I have the least amount of experience out of the three of us. But just working with them and receiving support from them has been a great experience for me.
One of the things about this network, which involves just all, you know, probably 40 agencies all across Talladega County, is we can't do it by ourselves.
Correct.
We weren't created to do things by ourselves.
Right.
We were created with relationships.
That's right.
And that's one of the really I guess the fundamental thing with
Correct.
This network is building relationships, working together, and we're going to make a difference in our county.
And so here's what's wonderful about this.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're not duplicating services.
Right.
So if there's something that you do really well, whether it's additional support with feeding programs in the summer or after school or for the dinner programs or whatever it may be, being able to coordinate those programs and those activities to put the people in the right place with the resources is what makes a difference, because it gets the service to the students faster. And that's what I love about the network, is that we're able to figure out where are the resources, where we need to send people immediately, and then we can get that support for those young people.
Well, we only have a couple of more minutes left.
All right.
Mention peach jar.
Okay, so.
Because this sounds like peach jar. What is peach jar?
And you're probably looking at me going, what is this guy doing? He's got all these programs in year one. So peach jar for us, peach jar is a company that we use. And a lot of the things that we've done have been high tech stuff because it's easy to do. You know, 95% of the folks in our community are using a smart device to access things online, whether it be social media, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. And so what we've done is we've uploaded this link. It's called Peach Jar. And so anyone that is wanting to get information out can submit their flyer or brochure to Peach Jar via this link on our website. So you go to our district webpage or your child's webpage, depending on what school they're in our school district. And you click on Peach Jar, you fill out the link, and you upload your document, and then Peach Jar will send it to us and say, hey, do you approve this? Well, if it's a non-revenue or non-for-profit thing, it's free, you know, but if it's something that's a revenue-generating thing, there's some cost associated with that, and so we can electronically send flyers and information to people just the click of a button.
Love it.
And it's about communicating with our people. You know,
right.
And if we know that that's where our people are, we want to meet them where we are. You know, I tell people to follow me on social media. My Twitter tag is SuperDega. Follow me at DegaSuper. And, you know, we have our Facebook page, and, you know, all of our principals have a Twitter account. Our school's district's Twitter page is Dega City Tigers. And so you can just check us out and see some of the things that are going on and see how really awesome Talladega City Schools are.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Thank you so
Absolutely.
Much for being here.
Yes.
We have covered a lot, and I know
yes.
there is so much that we didn't get to cover too. But
well, stay tuned.
Yes.
Stay tuned for the, we have our app that we're launching in June.
Okay.
We're going to launch a new app, a smartphone app for our school district in June.
All right.
Okay.
Talladega City. Lots of things
moving.
Here
we come. Here we come.
Thank you so much for being here.
Ma'am.
We will be back in just a minute with Marshall Pritchard, who is with UAB and is a med student here in Sylacauga. And we will be right back. Thank you.
It's Shawnee McNeil at South First Bank. This is a great time for you to buy or build a new home, or maybe refinance your present mortgage. Our rates are the lowest they've been in years, and that means saving you money. We've been helping our customers become homeowners in this area for nearly 70 years, and we can make our approvals right here in the office, and that means saving you time. We're located here in downtown Sylacauga. Come in and find South First, a better way to bank.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
At Marble City Pharmacy, we're more than just a drugstore. Our gift shop boasts some of the most unique treasures you'll find anywhere. Come in and browse the vast selection of jewelry, purses, clothing accessories, and crafts. Let our friendly staff help you find that special card or gift for any occasion. Our dollar wall features selected sale items, and we stock a wide variety of specialty items. And if it is a drugstore you need, Marble City Pharmacy was named the 2015 McKesson National Pharmacy of the Year. Visit us today at Marble City Pharmacy.
Connect to nature. Connect to family. Camping World is here to help you make lasting memories. With thousands of parts and accessories available, service nationwide, and RVs as low as $109 a month, Camping World has it all. Now is your time to connect to excitement with savings on thousands of RVs. Plus, enjoy Good Sam Elite membership with every RV purchase. Visit your local Camping World Supercenter or shop campingworld.com today.
The Allen Companies of Sylacauga with three locations to serve you: Highway 511, Highway 280, and Main Avenue. For all your convenience store needs, ice, drinks, snacks, and of course, some of the lowest priced gasoline at the pumps. It's the Allen Companies of Sylacauga. Highway 511, Highway 280, and Main Avenue. It's the Allen Company convenience stores.
You got it? Do not hit me again.
One of the phrases that we hear often, and matter of fact, the mayor said it to me just a moment ago, our children are our future. And you know, that's absolutely right. But you know what? Our children are our present also. And the Word of God says so much about it.
Love does do no harm to our neighbors. Therefore, children should be able to freely express the meaning of F-A-M-L-Y. Father and mother, I love you.
Were it not for the Children's Trust Fund of Alabama, we probably wouldn't be standing here today. And so it has been a great honor and privilege that I introduce to you Sally Longshore.
I just want to applaud the work you do and thank you from the bottom of my heart. You're in the trenches doing that work every day, and these children are going to benefit. And I think it's wonderful y'all always have young children here. That really reminds us what we're all about. Reverend Looney said, you know, they need to be protected, and it needs to be in the present. So I thought his words rang so true. Community knows there's so much we can do to keep any child from ever being harmed. So it's kind of a dual purpose for us. April is Child Abuse Prevention Month nationally, and our organization, our agency, is the state chapter of Prevent Child Abuse America. So it kind of serves a dual purpose. I know Margaret and the good folks at SAFE like to bring attention to those children, honor their memory, honor, you know, what has happened to them with the balloon release. But I come in to reinforce the idea that we all need to work together as a community to make sure that we educate, we inform, and we prevent child maltreatment from ever happening in the first place.
It's an emotional day. It's a day of remembrance. It's a day of celebration for all the good work that's being done across our county and state to protect children. But emotional in the sense that there are children that still are out there that we must protect and must provide the foundation for safety for those children as well.
Child abuse prevention is the only way that we're going to ever be able to make a difference in children's lives. We often get involved after it's happened, but we need to be involved and help people understand to prevent it from happening to begin with, because the abuse has a tendency to continue to follow the children even after the children are safe and protected. And talking about it and being aware of it is what makes the difference. Even the children know. So share with them, talk to them, and just be there for them. And that's what we need to be as a community.
One, two, three!
And you're watching the video from Tuesday's Child Abuse and Neglect Prevention rally, where we had the balloon release. This was in Sylacauga. What a beautiful day this was. And we had Sally Longshore from Children's Trust Fund. That was Linda Burton on the video, who coordinated the balloon release, her and Ollie Cates. Linda is the crib coordinator with Safe Family Services Center. Safe Family Services Center. And Ollie Cates, who is the fatherhood coordinator at Safe. And this was just a special day to honor and to remember children that have been abused in Talladega County. And this is a special month where we honor those children that have been abused. And as we come back from the break and from the video, we have a very special guest, Marshall Pritchett, who is with UAB. He's a med student with UAB, and we're so glad to have you here. You've been working out of the Davis Family Clinic for how long?
For 8 months now.
For 8 months. Okay, so you've been in your rotation through Coosa Valley Medical Center, and one of the things that I wanted the audience and when I talked to you, we've been working together somewhat.
Yes.
For the past, has it been 8 months?
Let's see. Yeah, it's been about, of that 8 months, I would say we started maybe in November.
November.
So I would say maybe the last 6 months.
And for the last 6 months, and one of the things that just struck me, you reached out to SAFE, and you have, and I use this word with Mr. Roller, but you have a passion for community and wellness, and you came over to SAFE, and we were looking at the gardens and being well and being healthy. I always like to start with our guest just hearing about you and your journey, what has brought you to Sylacauga and what has brought you here, and share with us just some comments about that and how you got here.
All right. So as a third year medical student, I think we have to do so many clinical rotations, if you will. Mm-hmm. And as part of a special program that we just started in Tuscaloosa about 2 or 3 years ago, they wanted to emphasize primary care. They wanted to emphasize community. So one of the things that we started doing is they would send students out that you would do a couple of rotations at a big hospital like UAB or DCH in Tuscaloosa. And then after that, you would go out to a smaller community and you would spend some time there. And in that time, you would get to see what a community practice is really like, the type of things that happen in that community. And hopefully at the end of those months that you're there, you've made some type of impact on that community. And so I got placed here, and I think it's been a great experience thus mm-hmm. far. I worked, like you said, in Davis Family Medicine Clinic. And I work primarily with Dr. Nix, but I also work with Dr. Clay and Dr. Renee. And then I worked with other doctors in the city in surgery, psychiatry, neurology, and pediatrics as well. And so that was just a wonderful, wonderful experience, just working with all those doctors and how they coordinate care with one another and how they really come together to make sure that the needs of Sylacauga and the surrounding areas are taken care of. And then, like you said, I did reach out and I wanted to try to make some type of impact, and SAFE seemed, and Get Healthy Talladega County seemed like they really had a lot of resources and a lot of things that they were already doing to empower the community, and I just wanted to be a part of that.
Well, I just have enjoyed so much hearing your story. And it was funny when you were talking with Mr. Roller earlier before the show mm-hmm. came on. It turns out you all know some people in common, too,
yes.
from where you grew up. Now, where did you grow up?
I grew up in Thomasville, Alabama. It's about 100 miles north of Mobile. Mm-hmm. And it's about, I'll say, an hour and a half south of Tuscaloosa, depending on how fast you drive. So it's kind of in the middle of West Alabama, if you will. We call it LA, Lower Alabama. Mm-hmm. So, but it's in West Alabama, and it's a small town of about 6,000 people. So, Sylacauga is a big city for me. But after that, I did go to Alabama A&M University in Huntsville, Alabama, or Normal, Alabama. And then from there, I went and got a master's from the University of Alabama through the Rural Medical Scholars Program. And I went on to medical school at UAB.
How did you decide on Sylacauga?
So Sylacauga was actually, it was just the best fit for me and my family. My wife works in Pell City as a veterinarian. And as such, when we were trying to decide where we were going to be placed, the school, because ultimately it really comes down to if we can find doctors who are willing and ready to educate medical students. And Sylacauga seemed like they had all the resources here. Mm-hmm. They actually have a lot more resources than a lot of other small towns. And so when we were trying to figure out where we were going to, where I was going to, I guess, get the next step of my education, who was in conjunction with the faculty and staff at the University of Alabama School of Medicine, we all decided it might be best. So I go to Sylacauga, and I must say it's probably one of the best decisions that I've made during my medical career.
Well, it's been a blessing to us to have you in this community. We're going to talk after the break about some initiatives that you're wanting to bring to the community. We're going to talk about your passion for healthy eating and some of the smoothies and some of the quick meals that are healthy. I'd love for you to share some of that because that's important for us as we are, as we're trying to get healthy. And there's this atmosphere of eating healthy and exercising and fitness. I'd love for you to share some of those recipes or some of your thoughts on that. And we can talk about that after the break. But so you talked about some of the rotations that you've had in the community. What was your favorite? What was your favorite? Where's your excitement there?
So I like them all. Uh-huh. And I like them all a lot. I think because of that, I think family medicine probably was part of my most favorite rotation. You just kind of get to see a little bit of everything during that rotation, where you see people who need to go to surgery, and then I will go follow them into the surgical suite. You see people who have psychiatric conditions, and you get to try to help them out as well. You get to see kids. Mm-hmm. So that kind of touches on pediatrics. You see a lot of people with neurological problems such as back pain and things of that nature. And so you really get to touch on a little bit of everything. And then if I need to, I always could go to those specialists and get even further education and see people who I can just see kids, or I can just see just people who have neurological conditions and understand how to treat those people and manage their conditions. So I think family medicine was probably the most all-inclusive, and so it was pretty good.
Well, you got to work with three rock star physicians that are in the Sylacauga community. When we come back from break, we are going to break, and we will be back in just a moment.
Hi, it's Shawnee McNeil at South First Bank. This is a great time for you to buy or build a new home, or maybe refinance your present mortgage. Our rates are the lowest they've been in years, and that means saving you money. We've been helping our customers become homeowners in this area for nearly 70 years, and we can make our approvals right here in the office, and that means saving you time. We're located here in downtown Sylacauga. Come in and find South First, a better way to bank.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
At Fort Williams Pharmacy, you won't find motor oil, garden hoses, or mountain climbing gear. No, they don't have that. What they do have is a professional, friendly staff that understands your needs. Filling prescriptions is their primary business, and they take it seriously. They also have a drive-through window for your convenience and free local delivery. Most of all, Fort Williams Pharmacy knows your time is valuable, so when it's time to fill your prescriptions, you need it done fast, friendly, and accurately. Fort Williams Pharmacy, our family, caring for your family.
Connect to nature. Connect to family. Camping World is here to help you make lasting memories. With thousands of parts and accessories available, service nationwide, and RVs as low as $109 a month, Camping World has it all. Now is your time to connect to excitement with savings on thousands of RVs. Plus, enjoy Good Sam Elite membership with every RV purchase. Visit your local Camping World Supercenter or shop campingworld.com today.
Coosa Valley Medical Center, one of the top 10 hospitals in Alabama, is also Sylacauga's largest employer. Services from the emergency room, to surgery, to cancer treatment, to post-stroke care. You won't believe what's right in your backyard. It's Coosa Valley Medical Center in Sylacauga. So, if you're sick, in Alabama, choose one of the top 10 hospitals in Alabama. That is Coosa Valley Medical Center.
Welcome back to the Get Healthy Talladega County Show. This is our last segment, and I've been speaking with Marshall Pritchett. I'm saying your name horribly every single time. Please say it correctly for me.
Marshall Pritchett.
Pritchett, and I have said Pritchard and Pritchett. Pritchett, thank you for correcting me on that. And but we've had over the past 6 months, we've been talking about community and talking about eating healthy.
Yes.
And tell us your story about how you made the change to start eating healthy and how that occurred.
Okay, so pretty much I was in college and I was eating what college kids eat, mostly ramen noodles, vienna sausages, just college kids food. And after college, I felt that I needed to probably start cooking things and not have 3-minute dinners and things of that nature. And so I come to find out it's easier to cook healthy foods. It takes less time, for at least for me, and I enjoy what I ate. And so I would say probably at the beginning of medical school, I was still eating off and on unhealthy and maybe a little bit eating, I say maybe once a week I would eat healthy. And then after, I would say, second year of medical school and on, I've been eating pretty healthy. I do have my wife that I have to thank for that. She wanted to make the change and she wanted to eat healthy, and we were already trending towards that way. Mm-hmm. So we just decided to take the plunge together, and come to find out that it is easier to make a nutritious meal. It generally takes less time than it would to make fried chicken or something like that, where you have to go and you know, bread the chicken and do all these different things, heat the grease up. You know, I don't have to do all of that now. I can, if I want to saute chicken or bake chicken, I can put chicken in the oven and forget about it. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. Continue doing what I need to do and then take the chicken out. You know, after seasoning and everything, of course, and take the chicken out, and it's ready to eat. So I think that was the major change. Found out that I was losing weight along with exercise, and my wife was happy with it, and you know what they say, happy wife, happy life. So I think that's the main thing.
Learning that young.
Yeah, learning young.
Very good, very good. Now, what one of the projects that we're working on right now is, and this was an idea that came from you, was to create some opportunities in the community to share recipes, and we're working on a project right now with Strength and Stride. And Strength and Stride is something that Dr. Freeman and Margaret Morton created, along with Mandy Reams, to provide opportunities within the school system. So this is going on at Sylacauga City Schools to have an exercise time where they're working on goals, personal fitness, but then share the event that we're gonna have in the next couple of weeks.
Sure.
What you want to do with that?
So the program would be called it's geared towards Strength and Stride, like you said. Mm-hmm. But the event is called Dinner and the Smoothie. And what the event is coordinated around is mainly the smoothie, but we're going to try to find, we actually have now, I guess, different dinners. It takes less than 30 minutes to prepare. That's preparation, that's cook time, less than 30 minutes or less to cook these foods. They're healthy foods and they're tasty. And then we also, like I said, we want to center around the smoothie. Smoothie is a quick way. You can eat it for breakfast. You can drink it as a snack. And it takes 5 minutes tops to prepare. Mm-hmm. And you can put things that you don't like. I don't like carrots, for instance. So this morning I made a smoothie and I put spinach, I put carrots, I put blueberries, strawberries, and pineapple. And just a touch of orange juice and a banana in there. Mm-hmm. I put it in the blender for, 20 seconds, 30 seconds. It blended up really nice and fine. I put it in a cup and I drove off to 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And so we want to start thinking of innovative ways to get our nutrition because there are some foods people just say, well, we don't like that food. Or if we eat that food, such as collard greens or some type of vegetable like that, we need to add bacon grease or fat back or ham hock. Well, that has some nutritional value because you're eating the greens, but at the same time, you're still eating unhealthy things with the grease.
Mm-hmm.
And so we want to discourage that type of eating, encourage more healthy eating, and one way you can do that is through smoothies. And so I definitely want to put more emphasis on smoothies in the dinner, but we also want to try to find quick alternatives to eating out at, fast food restaurants. I know the allure of fast food restaurants are mostly that you can go in, you can order something, 5 minutes later you have a meal. Well, it might take a little bit more than 5 minutes, but you also have to think about the long-term effects of your health. Because when you have diseases out there, such as hypertension or conditions like hypertension, diseases like diabetes, these things can be affected by your nutrition. It can be affected by your weight. And so we want to make sure that you remain a healthy weight, that you remain as healthy as possible for as long as possible so that you can have a good quality of life. Because I don't think that is necessarily... it gives any doctor joy to prescribe pills and try to manage your disease through pills when we can prevent these things, and then we don't have to worry about you having to take medicines to manage hypertension or diabetes or heart disease or anything like that. So I think if we eat healthy up front, we can avoid disease on the back end.
There's a coach in our county, Coach Maddox, Grant Maddox, and one of the things that you're talking about the prevention and eating healthy, and he is a strong advocate for eating healthy too. And mm-hmm. one of the things he says is when his students started eating healthy, they noticed a change in their ability to perform. And we have so many students. Or student athletes that come not only from our county, but from the state of Alabama. And you talk about performance and getting those college scholarships. Eating healthy is going to put you over the edge. To help you to perform better. And tell us, talk to us more about the prevention and kind of the some of the things that you can do. When you're talking about heart disease and
Well, I understand that everyone is not going to go on to get a scholarship to become a college
yes.
athlete. But as far as staying healthy, and with along with Dr. Nick, from just like learning from him, noticed that about 150 minutes of exercise a week is good just for general health. Now, everybody's not able to go out there and run a marathon. But you can get out there for 30 minutes, 5 days a week, or you can go for an hour, 3 days a week, and you can get that exercise. And I would say try to get your heart rate, kind of get your heart pumping. You want to feel that burn. You want to feel you want to sweat. That's where you're going to get most of your caloric burning. When you're eating things and things of that nature, you want to kind of balance that with exercise. And I understand every day is not going to be just a great and healthy day. Sometimes you want fried chicken wings. Sometimes you want, those things. But try to have more good healthy days than you do non-healthy days. And so things you can do, have a smoothie in the morning. For lunch, try to center it around maybe a small salad and if you have to have meat, try to go for chicken or fish, and try to reduce the amount of beef and pork that you do have. And then, I'm not saying don't eat it at all, but just reduce the amount. And then for dinner, you can always, have some type of chicken or pork. There are different recipes out there that you can look up. A great website to go look up different things would be, nutritionfacts.org.
Nutritionfacts.org. Okay.
Nutritionfacts.org. And it actually has research and things, but it tells you in layman terms. There's a lot of videos out there on nutritionfacts.org as well. So if you don't like to read, then you can go and watch. It's a YouTube video, but it tells you a lot of great information about different smoothies. You can try different recipes for smoothies, different recipes for dinners and different meals you can try, and most of them won't take you that long to prepare, and it can feed a family of four. Generally, is how their recipes work. But it also kind of gives you a little bit of backdrop about those meals, so you can say, well, science says that this meal is healthy. It's not just some random person out there saying, oh, well, with this diet, I lost 50 pounds. And with this diet, well, while it's great to lose weight, I think your health comes first.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that we should try to make people more healthy. And as a consequence of them being healthy, hopefully they lose the weight if that's what they choose to do. But I think our first priority should be on making them healthy. And you do that by eating more nutritious foods and trying to cut back on unhealthy foods as well as exercise.
Well, we have less than a minute left.
Sorry.
Tell me what is next on your plate. You'll be ending up here at the end of April, and then what?
After that, I'll go back to Tuscaloosa. I'll do another rotation, clinical rotation in Tuscaloosa. And then after that, I'll start fourth year. I'll interview for residency jobs, which is the next step after medical school. And after that, hopefully I'll find myself a home. Me and my wife can find a home working in the medical practice.
Well, we hope to see you back in Talladega County. thank you for being with us. Thank you for the programs that you're wanting to start. And hopefully they will blossom all around Talladega County. I know churches was one of those,
yes.
is eating healthy in our churches, and
yes.
boy, are we are guilty. Thank you so much for being with us again. Thank you for watching the Get Healthy Talladega County Show, and we'll see you next week.
Mm-hmm.